We have a really special guest with us today. We're very privileged to have her. She's an Emmy-nominated director and choreographer. She's worked with all kinds of celebrities, including Michael Jackson, Alicia Keys, Beyonce, Lady Gaga, and many more. And so she's a dedicated Christian who loves Jesus, and she's going to talk to us today about some of the challenges she's experienced in serving Christ in that environment. And I know many of you in here are excited to be able to talk about, okay, so what does that mean for my life in the future as I go into different areas and I begin to serve the Lord? What does it look like to be a Christian in what's oftentimes a very secular atmosphere? If you could please give a warm Christian High welcome to Laurieann Gibson.
I feel like it needs to be.
Yeah, louder than that, right? Okay, there we go. Thank you, Laurieann, for being here. You know, she told me backstage that she's a little bit nervous. Could I get a big "We love you"? Ready? There we go. Okay, so
I love you too.
Thank you so much for being here today.
Thank you.
And so we're gonna start off just learning a little bit about her life and what she's gone through, how she got to where she is today. But before we do that, Laurieann, tell us, what are you currently doing in Hollywood, in the media today? We know you're a part of, you're one of the judges on So You Think You Can Dance. Is that right? And this is going into the second season.
Yes.
Okay, correct. What else are you doing?
Well, I'm presently very grateful to be here, yes. Thanks. I'm rebooting a show called Making the Band. Has anyone ever heard of Making the Band? Okay, great. Woo-hoo! I'm obviously working on the Grammys, and I work with everybody in the business. Jonas Brothers, Katy Perry.
Any fans of the Jonas Brothers out there?
And a bunch of other names that we'll go easy with on today. But just know that I work with some of today's hottest, biggest, iconic superstars, pop stars, and all the above.
So Laurieann, why don't we start with just telling us a little bit about your background, where you came from. Did you grow up in Hollywood? Was this always your dream to be a choreographer? How did your life start out? Did you grow up in a Christian family?
I was born and raised in Toronto, Ontario, Canada. Yes, I know Drake. Does anyone know Drake? Hey. I was born and raised in Toronto, Ontario, Canada, and at 17, I got on a Greyhound bus to New York City, where I wanted to study dance at Alvin Ailey American Dance Theater. I did not have a famous last name. I did not have a lot of money, but I had a dream. And I had a dream that I knew that God gave me very early because I was so passionate about that dream. I wanted to be a star. I wanted to be on stage. I wanted to have the ability to dance. And that's all I knew. But I knew that it was on a big level. I knew that it felt a certain way. I knew that I couldn't see it perfectly, but I could feel it. And I was a track runner at school, and I was very athletic, but it was something about the dance that always pulled me back to my passion. So I got on a bus, I went to New York City. I was actually illegal because I was Canadian. But again, that didn't deter me. I wanted to dance, that's all I knew. So I knew that a way would be made instinctually. At this time I was not saved, but I knew that I was always His because something was drawing me back to this feeling. And I now know that God gave me the gift because it was the evidence of who I am and who I would become once I gave my life to Christ. And so I went to Alvin Ailey, and I wanted to be a ballerina and study, and I am the most incredible ballerina on point. You can't come for me. I am not the white swan, but I am the black swan, and I love it, right? So thank you. And so I was in New York City from Toronto, Ontario, Canada. And New York, if you know anything about New York, it is incredibly intimidating. It is fast-paced, and there is just darkness around every corner. And you have to really understand how to stay focused on that dream, that feeling. And I studied for about 4 years in New York City, and then I went to an audition. It was a Heavy D audition, who was a rapper who was no longer here. And I met a man with a silver briefcase, and he said, "Hi, my name is Puff Daddy, and I'm the A&R of Uptown Records." Yeah, and then I met an artist by the name of Mary J. Blige, for which I started dancing for. And then I met a girl on the job, and she was like my best friend after a couple months, and her name was Jennifer Lopez. So I bumped into a community, yes, where obviously, I don't know if you know, obviously, again, and the story goes on, I met a girl who was in a girl group, and I started choreographing for her, and her name was Missy Elliott, and I choreographed I Can't Stand the Rain. I met and danced with Whitney Houston, who's unfortunately not with us, but I did all that from getting on a Greyhound bus at 17 with a dream that God had given me. Very shortly, I went to church, and it was my time, and God spoke to me, and the pastor was like, "If everybody was standing up," and then the pastor says, "If there's anybody who is not lying to God, please sit down." And so, of course, I was the only one standing up, because I was like, "Well, what does that mean?" And at that moment, the Holy Spirit fell on me, and I gave my life to Christ, and He began a journey in me that is amazing and awesome, and one that I am truly grateful for, that I stand in a readiness of being thankful for everything, for the breath that I breathe, for all of my toes and all of my fingers, and the simple things that you might not think I'm grateful for, I'm grateful for. And then I began to understand being in the world, but not of the world. Then I understood why I walked differently and I talked differently. And that they couldn't break me because they didn't make me. And that the Christians that I work for, Mary, and all of the ones that I began to even choreograph for, always didn't understand how powerful they were. There was always an appetite for the world, and I was like, "What are you guys talking about? I work there. We're better, we're faster, we're stronger. We move from a place of victory. Why should I not walk in that room and know who I am?" Because you think that what the world is, it's glamorized, but it's just that, it's not even real. It takes my gift to build the superstars. It takes my gift to walk in the room and give Lady Gaga confidence when no one knew who she was. It took my gift to choreograph every single step until I left, and now it somehow isn't the same. And then you look at that person who's out in front and thinks that they're the one solely responsible. But be very mindful of who you are and what gift that God has given you and what passion you're feeling right now where you are and what that's developing. And remember, there is nobody greater than the God that you serve or the gift that He gave you. So do not be moved by the rocks that they've got. Be moved by who you are and who you're called to be. You got to remember that. Because, yeah, they always say the artist before they say my name. I don't have a problem with that because I'm on a journey to rip away what you think that means so that you can ultimately really understand who you must become, not by the world standards, right? It's a reality. Thank God you go to a Christian school. I can't even imagine that. Can you imagine going to school and being able to worship God? Yeah! I had to go to a school riveted with darkness. I was the light in the darkness. I used to have a dream where I was in a pool of darkness. And I had light. I had a bright outfit on. And there was a man in a bright outfit on a mountaintop. And he looked like a superhero. Now I know it was you, Jesus. And I had light on. So I was always his, but I was surrounded by dark water. And he was telling me, "I'm going to place you someplace, and you will be the light in darkness. And even though the torrent and it felt like tar, you'll make it. You will be the light in the dark." So you have to be grateful because you're getting the information. You are the light. So do not be moved. Don't glamorize something that you are meant to dominate or create a way out.
Laurieann, I wanted to ask you because, you know, for a lot of young people as they're going through life, a lot of the stuff seems very, it's drudgery. It's just going through the motions of, oh, man, I want to get to where I want to be. And you yourself were talking about the process and going through that process and how important it is. Can you share with the students as young people and reflecting back on your life in your time as a young person, looking towards your dreams, why that process was so important and why you think it's important to enjoy the process of becoming who you are today?
What's the general age?
So we're looking at junior high on the sides. Can I get a shout out here from the junior high, right, on the sides over here? And then we have ninth over here. Shout out from the ninth graders over here. We've got 10th, right?
9, 10.
And we've got juniors right here.
Is that 11?
And we have the class of 2020.
Woo! Oh, my God.
Right here. So here they all are.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. At different times, it was, yeah. I think 9 was a little rocky for me. 12, I went to a performing arts high school. I knew exactly what I wanted to do by then. I mean, at different times, you know, it felt different for me. But I did not glamorize the outcome, or I wasn't only obsessed with getting it now. There was something about the process that people don't tell you is where the power is in becoming. It's in the process. It's right now that you are meeting me as the number one creative visionary in the business. Sunday is Puff Daddy's 50th birthday party. I will be there with everyone, from Kanye to Kim to everybody, Travis to the Kardashians, everybody. And the point, see how you react? That's the problem, kids. No. The point being, I am able to be exactly who I am right now, the light, because of the process. So you might think you take an Instagram photo and you want to look like that, or you want to be that, or you go to class, or you work hard and you're like, you expect to be at the top. But the reason why the process is necessary, because you're going to need to be defined by your gift in order to operate at the top, in order to get planted where you want to go, whether it's NBA, athletic, whether it's an author, a fashion designer, a singer, a dancer, a performer, a doctor, a scientist. You want to be at the top, and that is about the process and how much you put in on the way there. And a lot of people don't enjoy the process or celebrate the process. But if there's one thing you can hear and get from me is that in the process, I became great.
So that process.
Great, and I mean great. And I make a lot of money, and I have a great time in Jesus.
So.
The process.
So Laurieann.
Yeah.
What is the hardest thing about being a Christian with celebrities? I mean, you're around a lot of these people that have a lot of money. Uh-huh. They have a lot of influence, and for a lot of people, you know, it's easy to be dragged away down this essentially becoming, in a sense, egotistical and focusing on this. How do you live the Christian life, live out your Christianity in that environment and keep yourself from the temptations that come along the way?
Oh my gosh, there's so much to that. But I mean, by believing the word of God. I am in the world, but I'm not of the world. Lean not to your own understanding. No weapon formed against you shall prosper. Okay, so I really do believe this. Faith in what you don't see, but faith in me, Laurieann. You gotta hang on, because I'm gonna get you. I'm gonna make that Grammy performance when you put Gaga in the egg. I'm gonna make it perfect. Okay, faith. You don't see it yet, but you have to have the faith to make it, to allow it to manifest. Okay, so the word. I really do believe in my Lord and Savior. I really do believe I really do believe, therefore, there's no power in the trappings of the world, right? In the drugs, in the antidepressants, in, oh, you got to take off your clothes and show this and show that. No, there's no power in that. That's a distraction. So I am saved, sanctified, delivered, filled with the Holy Ghost. So why should I not be that? How could I not be that in the world? I don't care if I'm at the MTV Awards and I'm walking the red carpet. How am I not supposed to walk it? Saved. I am called. I am operating from a place of victory. Why am I going to act like I'm not? That's who I am. So instead of trying to separate your Christianity and your walk and your relationship with God, it is who you are. So the standard that He has in me and I have in Him, it operates in a place where someone's not a believer, where it's not built on solid ground. It's shaky, it's temporary. It is literally warfare, children. It is literally dark. There is no sense of true love. It's just the truth. We're in the world, but we're not of the world. So what does that mean? The world exists based on its interpretation of what we should value. All of that, all of the wrappers, all of the jewelry, all of the, you know, zhuzh, all of what seems amazing is empty. It's an illusion. It's man-made. We edit a video. We edit a song. We make you look a certain way on a photo. It's not 100% real, children. But you're real, we're real, because we know the truth. And that truth sets us free from being affected by the lie. It's actually great.
Amen. Amen? Well,
I think so. Are you guys dancers?
You want to, are we asking the dance question?
I just feel like they look like dancers, yeah.
Well, there's quite a few dancers in here. If you guys have a question that you want to ask, we have a mic up here. If you have a question that you'd like to ask Laurieann, feel free to come up, get in line here, and then we'll take your questions one at a time. But before we get to that, Laurieann, I wanted to ask you, has there ever been a time in your life as you've been working with celebrities and all that you've been offered an opportunity to do something that goes against what you know God has for you, but yet it's been something that's been appealing, but you've decided, you know what, I'm going to draw a line here. I'm not going to move to that because that violates my relationship with God, my relationship with Jesus Christ. Have you ever had an experience of that where you had to stand firm? And did you ever face any pushback for that? Meaning, did anybody ever... Was there a backlash? Because sometimes when you stand for Christ in a dark world, there's controversy and conflict and people get upset. Have you ever experienced something like that?
Every day.
Every day.
Okay. Yes, there's absolutely pushback and conflict because it is the opposition. It is warfare. It is working against what God has in me in order to utilize my gift to penetrate the darkness and lead someone to Christ and allowing more people to exist in the truth. So if our conversation is now about the truth versus glamorizing the darkness, more people would come to Christ and now we would be living a different life. Everybody. What's access for everyone? I came to give you life and life more abundantly. That's for everyone. So I met a girl who was not known, was not famous, and I worked with her, and she was not a believer. And so in my process, I was always challenged by things that she would want to do, and I would have to inspire her not to do them, right? I want to do this, I want to do that. No. What's the intention of what we want to do? Try it this way. And slowly but surely, she trusted my gift and everything. And you might now know her as Lady Gaga. And when we were very big and Bad Romance and Just Dance and everything's at number one and we're selling 55 million albums and we're selling out stadiums and I directed the Monster Ball live on HBO and I directed every single video and choreographed every single step, and now suddenly they wanted me to start doing things that didn't align itself with who I am and who I was at that time. And no, Judas, you want to make Jesus a what? A girl? Can you imagine being in that position, in that room, where the kids were actually considering it? And I was like, okay, Holy Ghost, what do I say? Give me some scriptures. Give me some words. I was searching, kids. I was searching because, you know, of course the church had told me I wasn't qualified. And I was searching and I was like, the blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus. I remember being in the meeting and all of the people of the world were like, that's a great idea. And I was like, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus. I kept pleading the blood of Jesus because I didn't know what else to do, but I know it was the power. Because remember, I did
amen,
really believe,
amen.
Right? So now I'm like activating. I'm like, because what the blood did for me, I knew it was real. Because I didn't grow up in the church, so I knew it was real. Because I experienced the healing transformative power. So I was like, we need some of that right now. And Gaga was sitting right beside me, and she was hanging on to my every word only because what my gift had done for her this far, she knew made her number one. It wasn't because she knew Jesus yet. It's because she knew she needed what I had. So God used that, right? And so she was sitting there listening to me. Now I was fighting the whole room of people who thought it was going to be revolutionary if we made Jesus a girl. And then I turned to Gaga and I said, let me explain something to you. Would you like it if they rewrote who you were and they said you were something you weren't? Well, Jesus is the savior of humanity. Every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess, including yours at one day or another. But what I'm not going to do is rewrite the truth.
Amen.
And I'm, yeah, yeah. And I'm saying all that to say every day they challenge that which is within me and that purpose that I have and that perfect way that God has made me and is making me and is designing me to be effective for such a time as this and to be able to tell you early, yes, you are the light. You are the one with the power, with the purpose, with the presence. So don't be intimidated when you go into the world or you meet someone that's not a believer. Pull those shoulders back and understand who you are and who you're called to be. Needless to say, I had to direct the video, and I did. And I did not allow anyone to utilize the opportunity to create a visual that could perhaps plant a seed in someone else's mind that would lead them down a different road. And so, as a believer, you are operating every day as the option. Literally and figuratively. And that's why I'm sharing that story, because you would never believe that it wasn't in a church or it wasn't somewhere where it's supposed to be, that warfare, that the miracle of who God is in my life was actually bigger than anybody in that room. And I wasn't a preacher and I wasn't called to be a preacher, but I was called to be evidence and carry his glory. So that's what I'm going to do and that's what I'm going to believe in, right? And it was effective and it was in real time. It wasn't in a man-made circumstance so you could touch it. It was in a real life situation where I was really in the room with a superstar and I was really experiencing the warfare.
Wow, that's, praise God, that's incredible. So, Laurieann, you're really in the heat of the battle. I mean, you really are in a spiritual war on a daily basis.
Yes, sir.
You're in a place where people are looking at you and they're saying, this woman represents Christ, what would she do in these circumstances? How do you keep your relationship with the Lord vibrant? Do you spend time listening to, for example, Bible teachers? Like, do you listen to David Jeremiah, our pastor here? And you were saying in the backstage that you actually are a fangirl of David Jeremiah. Is that is that true? Okay.
That's that's so very true. You guys would probably be all excited if I brought Jay-Z in here while I'm just like, hey, Jay, what's up? But Dr. David Jeremiah, I'm like, woo! Yes, because... Y'all are bugging up. But because in my house, right, TBN, because I live a very... I travel constantly. I've been all over the world with my gift. And when I turn on Dr. David Jeremiah, it is a connection. It is the word that I need. There is a standard there. And I am able to connect and understand who I am in moments of warfare. So you should really be honored. I can't even imagine. Can you imagine if I went to this school? Man, I would have let them have it earlier, sooner. Can you imagine? If I set out my journey knowing exactly who I was and whose I was, woo, they could barely take me now. So, you know, I think that y'all are really blessed and fortunate and should really understand that I am number one at what I do. And it's not because I'm in the world. It's because God gave me a gift very early in my life. And it's because Jesus Christ is ahead of my life, and he is in everything that I do. And everything that I touch is victorious. And every battle that I'm in, I win. And every demon that comes up against me to tell me I'm not who I am, he has no power. I say yes to what God told me I am and who I am. And by faith, I have continued to rise, and I am the best in what I do. And if you Google me, you will understand that you can't even believe I was here. But, yeah.
So if you guys have any questions for her, you can ask another question. You can ask a question. But, Laurieann, did you see... this is something that I thought was interesting. Did you see what was happening in Kanye's life? Because you've known him for a while. And did you see what was happening and the transition that was happening in his life? And how has that created more conflict in the celebrity world? Or is that, how? What's your thoughts on that transformation that's happened in his life?
I adore Kanye. I love him. His family is amazing. He's so talented and so gifted. And I did, and I do, work with him. And I worked with him prior to where he is now. And it is a beautiful transformation, you know? And to know him before without Christ is definite difference. And now that he is being used and has accepted Christ and accepted his purpose, it's exciting to me. And, you know, he obviously, you know, when God has us in a process or on a mission, you know, the challenges come. But I think it's just a sign of the times that you guys need to be listening to what I'm saying, because a lot of you, some of you are world changers. Some of you are destined to be next superstars or really big at what you do, right? So who in here has a big dream? Like, just raise your hand if you feel like it's bigger than your circumstance. But don't raise it like right here. Raise it up high. In fact, exactly. So right there, exactly. Right, exactly. So right there lies the problem, kids. That is the problem. If you ask these kids in the world today who they think they're gonna be, how much money they think they're gonna get, they're gonna jump up. And they believe in the idea of it. They don't even understand. And you that know, and that you that are saved and called, you should be jumping up. And understanding to be confident in Christ means that all things are possible through him. You have to really believe that. You shouldn't care how cool you look or how cool you don't look.
Amen. Okay, we've got our first question here. Come on up. Tell us your name and then give us your question.
Yeah. Get that mic.
Who's your favorite celebrity you've worked with? Oh, my name's Shane.
I'm sorry, what's your name?
I'm Shane.
Shane?
Shane. S-H. Shane.
Shane.
Yes.
Okay, nice to meet you, Shane.
Nice to meet you.
Okay, I want to tell you a secret, okay? Because this is part of what I do. The next time you grab that mic, right, I want you to put it up like this and be confident. And when you speak to someone, know who you are. And you speak like this to me, yes? Try it again. That's called artist development. Try it again. Okay, try it again.
My name is Shane,
yes!
And I have a question for you. Who's your favorite celebrity you've worked with?
My favorite celebrity besides you? I'm gonna tell you honestly, they're all my favorite for different reasons. Because each experience is different, right? But who, I really do love Miss Alicia Keys. Because I started her for her first album and eight Grammys, and over the years, she has a heart that is just not affected by her ego and what she has, and she's very, very nice, and I love working with her now. Some of the other ones are toxic, and you're constantly in the ugliness, yeah? So I think I love them all for different reasons, but she's one of my favorites.
Thank you.
Great question, Shane. Okay.
Thanks, Shane.
Up next.
Hi, I'm Mr. Ransom.
Oh.
Nice to meet you. My question is just, what are some of the challenges of working with the some of the people that have such strong personalities?
Go ahead.
Hey, guys, hold on. Shh.
Strong personalities. I have one too. I think that when I work, I surrender to my gift, right? So a lot of the times it's not really me, but it is the power of my gift. And it has a unique way of disarming someone who feels like they're everything. Because that is why I like to inspire people about the process. Because if you see me dance, I will disarm anyone. I'm not gonna dance for you today. I'm not gonna dance for you today, but Chris Brown, Justin Bieber, Michael Jackson, I am one of the greatest dancers alive, and I give God all glory and honor. So my, in the process, children, I learn, my gift, is sharp, that it disarms the ego, which is based in the world, based in the devil, based in the misperception. And I'm in my gift, which is God-given, so I know how to disarm the enemy. And once you disarm the enemy in someone, then who they truly are rises. And the appetite for good, the appetite for love, the appetite for God takes over. When you are the light, you're exposing it. Now, it's not easy, but I can't come and not expose that and require the greatness in you to connect with the greatness in me. And that brings that out of you. And guess what? People that are lost suddenly start to feel how beautiful it is to be found and loved. And that feeling sustains them long enough to hear from God and then surrender.
Thank you so much. That's awesome.
Yay!
Thank you.
Fantastic. Okay, come on up. Who's next? Dave, are you in line?
My name's Abby.
What's your name?
Abby.
Abby. Is it Abby? Hi, Abby. Did you ever watch a show called Dance Moms? I was on that too. Now, Abby, you know the rules. Say that again and lift that mic up and look out into the world and you be confident. Tell me your name.
My name's Abby.
Yeah! What do you want to ask me, Ab?
Have you ever taught anyone at any dance competitions or conventions?
Yes, I do. The Pulse, the main event, Monsters of Hip Hop. I have choreographers on that, but I was on Dance Moms with Abby Lee. So, yeah, I don't teach in conventions all the time, Abby, because I feel like a trophy sometimes isn't what I'm about, right? I believe in teaching my dancers about their gift and that the dream is the trophy, not just like a statue. But I want you to believe beyond just wanting to get a trophy. So sometimes I do. Yeah. Is that good? Are you a dancer? Yes, my tribe!
Hey, there you go. Thank you, Abby. Okay, next question.
Oh!
So, we've heard today that you are the best in the world at what you do.
Yes, sir.
And
praise God.
So, I would like to know if you could teach Mr. Conover your favorite dance move.
Okay, I can.
Okay, fine. I give in.
Are there any other dancers in here?
Let's have two or three.
Red, white,
students. Two or three students, come on up. Seniors. What, seniors?
I'm a dancer.
Okay,
all right. Well, let me just teach you. Come on. All right.
Oh my God.
Turn the knees. Okay, come on, move over. All right, come on. Okay, but you have to stand in the middle.
In the middle?
Yeah, boom, come on out. Okay, oh wow, tall. Okay, step in the line. Step in the line. Yeah, I'm gonna spread out. Okay, perfect. Okay, move out. Okay. Wow, okay, move down a little bit, guys. Okay, so you want, okay, so I'm just gonna show you one step from, obviously Just Dance, because that's what they played, right? But then I'm gonna teach you the freestyle too, right? Do you know? So I'm gonna catch you in 5, 6, 7, 8. You're gonna step on the right, hit with the left, step on the left, hit with the right. Slowly, children, you're going to step on the right, hit with the left, step back on the left, hit on the right. You got that? Okay. Now, this is a serious process. Now, when you step, yes, it's not what you do, it's how you do it. Right? So you need to step with all the confidence. Yes, thank you. You need to step with all the confidence. Listen to me. Say you know you can dance. I can dance. Exactly. Now, with all of that confidence, take that right step and stab that doubt with the left. Right, okay, good. Then step back on the left and stab that hater with the right. Okay, now we're gonna do that 2 times, children. So you're gonna go step, ha, step, ha, step, ha, step, ha. You already know, okay? Wait. All right, and then you go freestyle. Okay, so let me count you in. 5, don't say a word, Boomcack is in the building. That's my Instagram name if you wanna follow me, @boomcack. Ready? Let me see. 5, 6, 7, 8. Step and hit. Oh, dear Lord. Oh, my goodness. And oh, my gosh. Yes.
Guys, okay, wait. This seems to be, we might need a little bit more time, but you are from a place of victory. You can't fail right now. So listen to me. Step on the right, now hit the left. Now step on the left, now hit the right. Now do it again, and step, tap, listen to my rhythm, and this, tap, dum, dum, da, do, and I've had a little bit too much. Now add a little swag, okay. Oh my God, okay, all right, good. All right, wait, children, because I will never be defeated. Now, the other thing we want to talk about is freestyling, which is, I believe, everyone can dance. So I'm going to back up my process a little bit, and we're going to talk about your inner metronome, your inner dance, your own eight count, can't nobody do what you do. Let me hear you say that. Can't nobody do what I do.
Can't nobody do what I do.
Okay. So that requires you to close your eyes for 2 seconds. Everyone? Now, guys, we're gonna clap. Ready? Clap. Okay, not the dancers. Close your eyes. And now, start to move. Don't think. Feel. No, let your hands go. Don't think. Don't think. Hey! Don't think. Oh! A battle! Don't think! Don't think! Don't think! Don't think! Okay, good. Okay, good. Okay, open them. Okay, good. The art of freestyling. I want to play the music. Nobody else dance, because you guys are obviously great freestyles. Let me just see what's happening here. Okay, ready? Music!
Remember, but it's alright, alright, just dance. Gonna be okay, just do them, just dance. In another day, just do them, just dance. Gonna be okay, just dance.
Ready, 5, 6, 7, and hit, step, and freestyle.
Okay, good.
All right, so. Oh my God, okay. So everyone is going to freestyle, and then we're gonna connect and do the step, okay? You got it in you? All right, here we go. Don't drop, that was actually great. Okay. All right, everybody move up. Ready? Okay.
Name of the club, I can't remember.
You're up first.
But it's all right, let's
freestyle. Guys, listen, Linda, listen. You know you're good, do you? You know what Mama's talking about, right? You know that. That was amazing. Thank you for the foites. And who are you? And who are you? Oh, I need to hire you. Who are you? Who are you? And the magic. I mean, I feel like everyone in this school can dance. Like, real talk. That was amazing. Let's give it up for them. I thought that was so good.
Thanks, you guys. Thanks for coming up here.
Yeah. I'm like, you all have been this quiet, and you all have all those gifts.
Well, Laurieann,
I'm in shock.
We're just about out of time here.
Okay. Whew. I know. I'm in shock.
My heart is, like, beating really fast right now. You guys, I'm so sorry. We're out of time for questions. I apologize.
I just want to say I am in shock. This whole side, that whole side. You guys know what you're talking about. You know who you are. You know that you can do anything. And the next time I come, please don't be so quiet. Because that's what I'm talking about. I want you to have the confidence in what you need to get when you need to get it to go destroy the opposition, yeah?
Amen. You guys, yeah. Let's give a loud, loud, loud thank you.
Woo! Oh, thanks.
Laurieann, thank you so much. Can I give you a hug?
Yes.
Thank you.
Do you have time to be in a job? Oh, my God.
So you guys, hey, let's give one more hand to Laurieann Gibson and thank you for having her out. I don't think I could have imagined a better way to end with the last chapel right before Christmas here. Christmas is all about Jesus Christ and what he's done, how he can transform people's lives. He can take somebody from going in one direction and completely flip it around and redeem their life, raise them up from the dead, and give them a whole new life. And that's what he does for each one of us. And what is God asking us to do this Christmas season? He's asking us to recognize that and then pass it on, right? Pass on that relationship with Christ to the people around us. And hopefully what they see in Laurieann, what these celebrities see in Laurieann Gibson as they're drawn to the greatness in her that is because of God and Jesus Christ is ultimately what they see in us, is the goodness, the loving kindness, the greatness of Jesus Christ in us draws them to him as we point to him. Amen? Amen. Hey, let's close in prayer and then we'll let you go for lunch. Lord, thank you so much for the testimony of all the incredible people that have come this semester to share with us about their lives and how you've changed their lives, God. Thank you for Laurieann Gibson, Lord. Thank you for that light in what's often a very dark place, God, that you've used her to minister to so many people who need the goodness and the love of God. It doesn't matter whether you're a celebrity, whether you're very famous and rich. It doesn't matter whether you're poor. Everybody needs Jesus Christ, Lord. And we thank you so much for sending your son as a little baby in Bethlehem to ultimately become the Savior of the world who died on the cross for our sins. We love you, we praise you, we worship you, and we pray that many people would come to know you this Christmas season. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Merry Christmas.